Yeah, another 5 days and not a screen check. She'd be done with doing what she's doing, and hopefully her throat will be available to work with, because right now she's in really bad shape. But President of the United States has decided to go to war with the Republicans over the jobs program. You know, he needs their support. You know, he is so bipartisan. Basically, he is making threats. He's going to do it without their support. He's going to do this. They just passed another regulation, more union favoring regulations, which basically are going to cost the trucking industry billions of dollars if implemented. Well, what happened is they're just going to simply stop. They can't charge any more money, so they're going to simply stop delivering on a lot of places. It's going to take them too long to deliver to. Are they going to take longer to get there, which means the products are going to cost more for the consumer, which would just be another pissed off thing a consumer. I mean, you know, it's just one regulation after another one. Oh, also, President of the United States Obama has decided that the entitlements are off the, are, they're not on the table for the deficit cutting thing. What is going to be on the table is tax hikes on the wealthy, which are, and businesses, which everybody knew was coming. You know, because you can't, you know, he has no spending cuts, just tax hikes and cutting the defense budget. I mean, who would have thought he would have done that? But here's another good one too, folks. A Health and Human Services spokesman, Silverian, said Secretary Catherine Sebelius will not go forward with a long-term health care plan, and I said it's fully sustainable, which means they were told from day one it couldn't be paid for, but it didn't stop the Obama administration from pushing it through anyway. So does anybody think they're going to stop the program, since they all know that long-care medical care cannot be paid for under any circumstances? And then, you know, you're going to love this. This is one of the most brilliant things I heard. The President of the United States is getting strong support from Republicans for his re-election. He's gotten support from nobody except the Black America, and they're, you know, that's it. And his support among them has fell by 11%. Basically, the United States government lays gold spill blame on BP. Well, yeah, only problem is that Obama gave him permission to do it. So therefore, a great percentage of the problem is on him, and it's not on the you know, on the BP. You know why he did it with BP? Because BP basically is one of the largest green companies in the world also, and he figured, well, you know, they'll support me in my green plan if I let them do their work in the Gulf of Mexico. Basically, here's a good one too. Another one from the Democratic Party. House is expected to follow the Democrats' leaders' promise to support the Obama jobs plan. Well, I know the money bubbleism, that's a little old money bubbleism, that if you depend upon the other party to elect you to office, you're never going to be, you're never going to win office, folks. So the Republicans will win the support of the people that sent them there to do the job they're doing, and they won't win the support from the other side. So I don't think, if I was a Republican, I'd be too much concerned about losing my seat for hanging to my principles that you were sent to do. Now, the guys upstairs, I could expect they're going to lose their seats. I mean, because the old guard refuses to change, period. World policymakers see darkening outlook, but don't worry. The United States government came to the rescue of Europe by printing a lot of money over the next 6 months. It's going to be totally worthless to prop up Greece and all those other countries because their banks are on the verge of collapse. Another good one. You don't think that they're doing spinning. Obama claims victory in a special election losses because it shows the discontent with Bush and the Republicans, and how the people are demanding change, and only the Democratic Party can give them that change. Well, you know, one was supposed to be, if one was running a popular attorney general who was expected to win the seat, because they'd only, the Republicans, the Democrats actually won that district the last election when Obama was president, running for president, and a second one has been in the Democratic's hand for almost a century, and it was Chuck Schumer's old seat. So They're very unhappy about that, but it was Bush and the Republicans' fault, though. The House and FBI and a senator probing a $528 billion loan to a failed solar company because, you know, but George Bush's fault because George Bush and the Republicans approved it. Well, no, George Bush turned it down, which they continue to keep forgetting. And it's a simple question. Do you think the President of the United States would give somebody $528 million for a $50,000 campaign contribution? No, you have to look further. I mean, that's not sensible. He's not a good businessman, but he's not stupid when it comes to money. So think for yourself. $528 million, I got $50,500. There's something else is going on there, folks. Google buys a got to buy with Open Table and Yelp. Yeah. And this morning, Yahoo, AOL, and Bing and Microsoft got together to combine advertising so they can go up against Google in the market now. So, Tasami Town, Ifanizes Japan Incorporation. Dilemma is, well, the problem comes is that you can't guard against it. Tasami, not tsunami. And no matter how well you build something, if the bigger the waves, the more difficult it is for you to figure out what to do. I mean, if the things were built to be, you know, we build things for floods that are like 15 foot tall. If you have a 16 foot flood, you're in trouble. You know, they do happen. You cannot, the trick is, no matter how great you are or how brilliant you are or how great your forecasting abilities is, there's always that time when things don't go that way. Euro is up today. Even though it hits a 10-year trough on yen because of the United States government and central banks propping up the euro. You know, soon they said the euro has been a failure since day one, and they continually refuse to admit that it's a failure and continually pumping more money in it. Another one. The middle class is collapsing, but don't worry. Bush and Republicans are blamed for the dwindling middle class under Obama. Because they set in motion things that you know that Obama has tried to correct, but unfortunately Bush and Republicans have stood against him on every single issue. I mean, and unless I'm wrong, Bush is not the president. And as they said, I heard him talk this morning on Bloomberg that the president of the United States had all the arrows in his quiver because he has the Justice Department, he has the Senate, he has the presidency, he has the Federal Reserve. All of these things are his bailiwick, folks. They're not in the Republican houses. The Republican House can pass one piece of legislation after another, but it just dies because, we put it this way, the Senate, in violation of the Constitution, has not submitted a budget in 2 years. It doesn't look like they're going to. The hacker group draws increasing scrutiny from feds. Okay, we're going to put it this way. You don't think that these females in Hollywood are not putting naked pictures on their cell phones so that they can have the cell phones hacked and then sent out over the internet so they can actually be nude and get away with saying, well, these were private pictures. No one was ever supposed to see them except our closest boyfriends or whatever. Yeah, I mean, we've been doing this. I can remember... I remember an actress that played Miss Goody Two Shoes that basically fought tooth and nail in court to have pictures, you know, seized from one of the scandal magazines. And then it turns out, you know, in her memoirs, like about 50 years later, folks, you know, I mean, she was really a hottie when she was younger, that she actually had those pictures taken and her then husband basically left them sitting somewhere where he knew some members of the scandal publication would find them, and they just immediately grabbed them and published them and sort of, you know, boosted a failing career. You know, Miss Goody Two Shoes, the constant virgin isn't such a virgin after all, is she? Well, the pictures were also staged. That's what she said. Basically, hackers send fake terror alert from NBC Twitter. Well, the problem is, it makes you think twice. I mean, I'm looking at a thing here that only 43% of the businesses in the entire country consider their cybersecurity safe because there's... I mean, I know a couple of kids that have been banned from using telephone forever by the telephone companies because they, you know, geniuses in college when they were like 10 years old, they gave everybody on the college campus free uses of cell phones, folks. And, you know, we're talking, you've got 10-year-olds that basically, you know, in school that are forging, you know, making money, $100, $25, $10, $100 bills and stuff. So, you know, you can't protect against this stuff. Here's one too about the flooding. Even though history will tell you where flooding is most likely to be, people will still build in those areas because they're the prime area to be built upon. So then we have Amani Butler's March for the Animal Kingdom. Often what you need to happen is the last thing that ever happens.